It started as a day race, now it runs at night. Welcome to the Bahrain International Circuit, and welcome to the Bahrain Grand Prix. There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best, of course, at turn one, and then another soon after into turn four. 15 corners here, six to the left and nine to the right, and we could see one or two flat spots into that tight left-hander of turn 10. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And it's Charles Leclerc in P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Russell, Norris, Perez, Sainz, Oscar Piastri, Fernando Alonso, Ocon, Gasly, Stroll, Magnussen, Albon, Tsunoda, Bottas, Joe, Hülkenberg, Sargeant, and Daniel Ricciardo fills the last spot on the grid. With preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of this lap. No rain expected, no rain expected for the time being. No need to worry about the tyre condition for now. Everything's looking good. Now use DRS. DRS now available. Okay, mate. Really good stuff. That's P10. It puts us into a great point scoring position. You're in the top 10 now, keep it up. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 2.0 seconds. Okay, we're approaching the pit window. You're going to be on softs. Yuki is in the pits. Yuki in the pit lane now. Tire condition still looking good. Okay, so the gap to the car ahead, 1.7 seconds. Okay, we're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can. Stroll behind. Our gap behind is 5.3 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. We think they've got one more stop. Your last lap time was a 1:36.4. Okay, let's go now. Come on. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 11.8 seconds. The fastest lap at this point in time is a 1:33.0. We don't have the data for that, I'm afraid. That's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Gap to your teammate behind is 15.2 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. They're currently 17th place. And the time last lap was a 1:35.2. Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, clear. And gap to the car in front is 4.0 seconds. Okay, Yuki's out of the race. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Red Bull are our winners today after showcasing some incredible driving. There's been a huge push from them lately to stay competitive with the other teams, and they're certainly proving themselves. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.